All right, so good afternoon, viewers. So here we bring another ranker, another topper to all of you from DAMS. So today we have Dr. Krishna Prasad, who has scored rank 10, JIPMER November 2017, and rank 80 he scored in AIMS November 2017. So two phenomenal ranks, and definitely his JIPMER rank is rank 10, something that we all dream of. So I would like to congratulate and welcome Dr. Krishna Prasad.
Thank you very much, sir.
And he was our regular batch student in DAMS Chennai, 2017 regular batch student. He has finished his internship only in March, and he has been very regular in all the lectures. So here is, we will discuss a couple of things with him, so that will enlighten all of you for future. So, Dr. Krishna Prasad, my first question that I want to put to you, so that we can speak with our viewers and all those PG aspirants and all those students who are even still in their MBBS, is that how were you during the lectures? I mean, what was your awareness level? Because why I'm asking you this, because this is one thing that I feel, being a faculty also, that we try to give our maximum as far as, you know, our lectures are concerned. But what I feel is that your awareness during that lecture, your 100% attention is very important. So what do you say, what do you have to say about that? Please enlighten us.
First of all, I want to show my gratitude to my parents, God, and my faculties to bring up me to this level. Then regarding concentration, it is impossible to have anybody to have 100% of concentration for in the act they have been engulfed, engaged. I think as much as possible we have to pay our attention for a minimum of 45 hours. Then for 5 to 10 minutes we have to take a small break, and then we have to resume our activities.
Yes.
That's my point of view regarding concentration.
So attention span is very important, because what I feel is that the time that you invest in even the first reading, that first reading is also very important. So what, at times I've seen students, you know, they feel that, you know, okay, I'm just going through a reading, that's a random reading. No, but try to utilize as maximum time as possible. Try to get the best out of it, since you're investing a lot of time and your energy into that.
Yes.
Great.
Sir.
Thank you so much. So second thing that I want from you is that, how would you share your experience as far as our grand tests are concerned, and our you know, subject-wise tests that were conducted after the lecture, the grand tests that you have appeared for. How many grand tests did you appear for before writing the final exam?
I appeared for nearly 5 grand tests, including 4 mock tests of semi-final and a final, plus 3 or 4 grand tests.
Okay, so in totality around 9 to 10 mock pitches. I can say 9 to 10 mock tests. Great.
And my one more suggestion is that it's of no use while you attend the class test on the day of its session itself, because you know that you will be knowing everything.
Yes, yes, yes.
My suggestion is that take a nap of 2 weeks after the first reading, then you should take the class test.
All right. So for all the viewers in DAMS, what we do is we conduct class-wise test after finishing the class, and then there is a grand test which is held on the third Sunday, and that's on the online platform that we have. So what he's trying to say is that appearing for a grand test is probably more important than appearing for a class test, because that will give you a bigger insight about your preparation, and I think that's probably his way. All right, so that's very productive for all of us. Now there is one more thing that I want to ask, that how were the notes important? The notes that you made in the regular classroom, how were they important, and how did they contribute to your queries, and how did you make them in sync with the knowledge that you acquired during MBBS?
I made class notes, and I used to revise class notes. One thing I want to mention that if nobody can provide 100% of the subject within the class span of 3 days,
yes.
So you have to put your additional effort to make the notes something about 80% of the subject.
So practically, you kind of collaborated with everything.
Yes.
You took help of the notes also,
notes.
And you made your own thing also, and you collaborated
yes.
them, and then you you know, completed your subject. Great.
But we have to marry a single source.
Yes.
At the time of revision, that is the main thing.
You can't spill over the things.
Yes, sir.
You cannot have multiple sources of information, because it becomes very difficult to revise, I guess. So you need to concise your notes.
And make it a single source during the time of revision.
Single source. So that is again a very important message, that you should have a single source, as he's saying. All right, now coming to the application of the social platforms. Like we have DAMS Exclusive Club 2017, how regular you were in that club, and how did you analyze the importance of the apps that we had, eMedicos, the mop-ups that you have attended over that? So please enlighten us.
Regarding DAMS Exclusive Club, I used to visit the club whenever I bored while reading, so that I can read lots of doubts of the others, so then I can learn from others' mistakes.
Okay. So practically, I think on the DAMS Exclusive Club, you're seeing where others are going wrong. that is what we can conclude. Great, great. It's important to learn from your own mistakes. It's important to learn from other mistakes also. That's a very smart move. And I must say, the toppers have this instinct also that they not only learn from their own mistakes, they also try to analyze where others are going right and where others are going wrong as well. That's a very smart move. That's a common gut feel of the toppers. All right. So how was the role of the images and the image session that the DAMS visual treat that we conducted? I guess you attended that in
Satellite
Center in Madurai.
Madurai.
So that's one beauty of DAMS visual treat that we conducted in Delhi and we display to all more than 150 centers. So how was the role of DVT in your revision? I mean, how did you use DVT in your revision strategy for the final exam?
DVT gave me an information about how the picture questions can be framed.
Hmm.
And how can I tackle those questions if I come to meet these questions.
Okay. So somewhere I think that formed a good part of your revision.
Yes,
also.
Sir.
You could recalculate the things and you
yes.
could analyze the things again. Now there's one thing that I would like to ask from you also, and that is something which all our viewers want to know, all the aspirants want to know, that what was the day one strategy that you had in your mind when you started preparing? I mean, I want to know that first thought with which you took a chair and a table and you sat down. The first thought that you have to share with our viewers.
Regarding on starting day one, everybody will be feeling enthusiastic because at the time we have just finished MBBS and we have a great hope that we have finished MBBS, that much career we have. But as the days progress, it's not only for me, it's for all of the medicos, most of them loses the hope.
Yes.
But my idea is that when you lose the hope, just to go back and take MCQs. So that while solving MCQs, if you come across more of positive responses,
yes,
you will be feeling more motivated that
yes.
how I read, so that you can go back and have your look.
Yes. So practically what he's trying to say is that, you know, any time when you are done with your theory part, when you are done with your reading part, at that point of time you have to go back, you have to solve your MCQs, and that will not give you a feel-good kind of a thing, but also you will... At the end of the day, see, in the exam, you have to solve MCQs.
Yes,
so you will be applying your knowledge in the form of an MCQ.
It will also get rid of our hopelessness.
Yes, that will give you a little hope also that, yes, I'm going on the right track. Basically, all we need to do during preparation is to make sure and to believe that, yes, I'm on the right track.
Yes,
and practically, this is again a smart move which he has conveyed to all of you. I'm so thankful to him that even in that moment of despair, even in that moment of hopelessness, he never wasted time. He utilized that time in solving MCQs, which at the end of the day is going to be productive for him. So this is something which is very important. See, try to understand. Correct me if I'm wrong. Monotony is something which has to happen with every student. I'm sure monotony
yes,
must have happened to
Definitely.
You also. So monotony has to happen. It is our way of dealing with that monotony. Very good, doctor. Very good. There's one more thing. And as we all know that last 40 days are
yes.
there. And at this point of time, the stress level is shooting up like
Worst
anything.
Time.
So we're ready, yes, you use the right word, people are ready to burst even. So there's one thing that I want to ask, that at this point of time, many of our students, many of your fellow aspirants, at one point of the day, I'm sure they feel, I don't think I'll be able to do that. I think this is hopeless. I think I'm not be able to do that. So I'm sure this must have come in your life also, in your
Definitely.
Preparation also. So how did you deal with that? Please enlighten us.
Mm-hmm. We are not genius to know these 100% of the subjects because we are just undergraduates. Then my strategy is to we have to know 70% of the subjects, of almost of 19 subjects, but we have to know the 100% of what we know the 70% of subjects.
Yes.
That is my strategy. And more of our funding of getting new things, new updates, that is not at all a matter. My strategy is just to build up the basics, so that you have to build on the basics and correlate with clinically
yes.
the basics.
So, as you have seen and you have heard, he believes in abstract thinking. He wants to have a concept and he wants to make generalizations out of it. this is what I have learned about him, that he's very good in understanding the concepts, and he feels that, okay, just tell me the concept. He just understands the concept, and he makes his own generalization about that topic, about that subject, about that MCQ. And he's not very fond of, you know, going for alien MCQs, okay, this syndrome, that syndrome. He wants to stick to the basics. And what he has said is a very beautiful thing, that we cannot achieve 100%. We can achieve 70%, but of that 70%, we have to achieve 100%. So that is something very important that you should know how to, you know, revise the things in time. So you were targeting Jipmer, it seems.
Yes,
and what was your special strategy for Jipmer that you had in your mind? And this is for the aspirants who are targeting for the next Jipmer exam.
I don't have any separate strategy for Jipmer.
Great.
Only for PG I had a separate strategy, but
yes,
for NEET, AIIMS and Jipmer, I had made the same strategy. Because they are more of basics and clinicals, some factual questions. But like PGI, there are more of factual questions and multiple responses, so we have need a separate preparation for PGI. But rest of the three, we can make a same preparation with basics itself.
So he had a separate strategy for PGI, which he has appeared for. The result is still pending, and hopefully we will have another fantastic rank in PGI also from you, sir. Now, there is one more thing that I want to ask, that thousands of people are now preparing, and their countdown has begun, and last 40 days are there, and you know, the pressure is like anything. So if you are into that place, you have 40 days left with you without much of a hope, not scoring very good marks in a grand test, what do you think should be the strategy for last 40 days? I want you to share the strategy for their revision. See, whatever they've finished, they're finished.
Okay.
But how they can revise the things in the most productive way, please inform to all the people.
I will group the subjects into three categories.
Very good.
Basic subjects like first year, second year, because they contribute a lot of, lots and lots of to the question paper.
Basic subjects as in from
first and second year.
First and second year. Anatomy, physio, biochem, physio, patho, pharma, micro. Okay.
Then short subjects. Because our subjects are high scoring with less knowledge. Because
less
most
knowledge
of the topics are repeated, and even questions are also repeated. Then
short subjects as in skin, anesthesia,
sarpo,
radio, psychiatry, orthopedics.
Sarpo.
Very good. So what he's trying to say, that invest less of, they need less time and more productive. They're more productive.
Definitely, sir.
Yes. And third category.
Third category is long subjects.
Long
medicine
subjects.
Surgery, OG pediatrics and SPM.
Okay.
First build the basics. Concepts, basic concepts like risk factors for some carcinomas. Then management is a differently entered category. We will go deal with the surgery. But most of the carcinomas, we will deal within pathology.
Within pathology.
And for micro and micro, most of the infectious diseases will come under micro.
Okay.
Therapeutics also comes under pharmacology. So there is no need for to revise medicine. We can keep the medicine at the last 2 days. It's enough.
Wow, that's fantastic. Now, I hope, viewers, you have heard about this last line which Dr. Krishna Prasad has used, that we have left medicine for the last time. Why? Try to understand, this is what we have been emphasizing at DAMS right from the day one, connecting the dots. Connect the dots of the basic subjects to the subjects like pathology, and then connect it to the rest of the subjects. So, because that in this way, if you cover the subjects, then the clinicals will become automatically very easy. So in these last 40 days, whatever you have read till now, try to get all the things in sync with each other, so that you have the final things ready in your head, so that when a question comes, you apply your reflex and solve that MCQ within a frame of time. If you have scattered the things, and if you have read them in a scattered way, I don't think you have that much amount of a memory retention.
At the last time, we cannot able to cope up all the things.
Yes, because you are already under a lot of pressure, and then you won't be able to correlate the things and mark the final answer, and then you get confused. Despite knowing the topics, despite knowing the concepts, but in a scattered way, that becomes a big problem. Very good strategy. So, last minute strategy from him is to, sync all the things together and make sure that you channelize them, in a good way. I'm sure, Dr. Krishna, that there must be some part in your preparation, some part of time in your preparation, then you must have also felt the same way, that I don't think I'm going to be able to make it. So, what kept you going? What kept you moving? And what kept you moving at such a pace that today you have scored November 80 and AIIMS November 80 and Jipmer rank 10 and hopefully a good rank in PGI also. So what was that one thing that kept you moving even in those times of stress?
Our prayers and our my hard work.
Hard work. So basically, it is a very important fact for all of us to understand that you should not lose hope. You should believe in yourself. You should believe in your hard work. Now, I would like to know that when you were attending our regular lectures at Chennai, who were those faculties who inspired you most, whose lectures you really enjoyed? So, please tell us about that.
I can't such words to tell because I enjoyed almost all the classes.
But somebody who inspired
somebody,
you most?
Sumar sir.
Yes.
Then I realized that how Pradeep sir had taken such classes after having come from Jaipur to take class on next day.
Next day.
2 o'clock. Then I can't.
Okay. So basically, I'm glad that you enjoyed the lectures, and I'm glad your association with DAMS. Did you access to the videos of DAMS Delhi on the YouTube channel?
Yes, sir. I used to see the usually edge preparations like integrated medicine.
Integrated medicine. The Unplugged series viewers that
yes,
we conduct at DAMS, and we have had many lectures
because
before.
It correlated micro pathology and medicine surgery with everything.
So try to analyze, you know, if you analyze his words, in every statement of his, he's trying to sing the things. Even the videos that he liked, they were those videos which were conducted by us in an Unplugged series. There's an Unplugged series that I would want you people to go and see. It's on DAMS Delhi YouTube channel. On YouTube you can search and you can see the various videos in which anatomy, radiology, pathology, radiology, anatomy, microbiology, orthopedics, radiology, we've clubbed together and we have presented them, many videos. So they give you an integrated approach in which you can have an understanding of the topic on a clinical tangent. So that is something which is very appealing.
Like this is a style of aim. Nowadays aims and need questions.
Yes. The pattern is going towards that. The pattern is
yes,
going
sir.
Towards that, and that was the reason why we started doing those videos. So you regularly watch those
yes,
videos. Great. Now there is one thing apart from that. You know, now that you have scored this fantastic rank, what of course PGI result is pending. But what is that one branch that you are planning for? I mean, where do you see yourself doing post graduation?
Myself, I wish to do pediatrics or MD general medicine. So
okay.
That you see, because these two fields we can. And learn from physiology to pathology.
Okay. So basically he's targeting medicine and pediatrics, where also he's trying to, you know, sync all the things together.
It's
and he's trying to bring that, you know, connecting the dots in the clinical front also. Fantastic. I'm sure you are a great academic person and you have a highest amount of inclination in academics, and it is clearly evident from his talks that, you know, he has always loved what he has been doing or learning to do. So his passion is quite resonant and evident, and that is visible, and that is visible not only, you know, in this conversation but in the ranks also that he has scored. Any last minute message that you want to give to your fellow aspirants, considering one thought in mind, that it is the moment of, you know, stress and what they should focus upon. Like I'll divide it into two parts. A motivation message that yes, it is possible in your words. And second, regarding the subjects, I want you to give them an insight about that. Okay, this subject, this topic, this subject. I mean, your guesswork is as good as now ours because you know you are a fantastic ranker. So please share the message
first
in two terms.
I will give you motivation message, but in my vernacular, Tamil.
Yeah, of course. In your vernacular, absolutely.
It's a Tirukural named, it's even liked by Abdul Kalam, which
okay.
Motivated him. Daivathal agavidanum uyarchithan meivurutha kuditharum.
Okay.
Even if the fate or God has gave up, it's the perseverance of one which give pace to its effort.
I'm sure you must have enjoyed this, and this is something, you know, even I'm feeling quite motivated at this point of time. Sir, can we repeat in both the languages again?
Okay.
Just looking at the camera.
Daivathal agavidanum uyarchithan meivurutha kuditharum.
And how do you translate in English?
Even if fate or God has gave up or shown their hands, it's the perseverance of the one which pays for his efforts.
Fantastic. The perseverance is more important than your destiny. I think probably that is the bottom line. Your perseverance is basically more important than your destiny. Your perseverance can make you achieve any heights, and your destiny or fate is even nothing in front of this. So that is something I really liked it, and I would like to explore more of it in Dr. Abdul Kalam's words also. And yes, what subjects, and see, I want you to give them a brief about the subjects for preparation, the hours, the kind of revision. I mean, something, suppose if you are preparing for it, I mean, with the same kind of zeal now, so how would you go about it?
I would go, previously I told that I will go maximum for basic subjects, first six subjects, anatomy, pathology, pharmacology, physiology, micro.
Okay.
Then I will go ten to twelve days for short subjects, SARBO subjects. Then remaining 10 days, I will go with the difficult topics which I won't recollect in the long subjects.
Okay.
But for regarding consent of SPM, it is difficult to remember the programs and incidents and the prevalence rate. I will suggest be sure with the epidemiology, biostatistics, screening. These two are very high yield. These three are very high yield for any exams.
Epidemiology, biostatistics,
and screening of
diseases and health programs, of course. So they are very important. Okay, all right. So we have to divide it in this way. Now, there's one more query that keeps coming up quite often, and even I'm asking this query that how to divide. First question: how to divide my day? That how much time should I dedicate to revise my notes, and how much time should I dedicate for solving a grand test or an MCQ paper?
My strategy is, if everything is monotonous, it will be boring.
Monotony kills you. So you have to, you have to shift the things according to the mindset.
My strategy is that 2 to 3 hours of solving MCQs. You should be solving the MCQs randomly, not from the subjects you are reading that time.
This is again a very good thing, everyone. I would like to, convey this thing again, what he has said, that you should solve MCQs on a random fashion. It's not that, today I have read microbiology and in the night I'm solving MCQs
because
from microbiology.
At the time it will be striking.
At the time it will strike you. So that is something which is not very productive, I guess. So what he has been trying to say is that, read one subject, when you feel monotonous, after revising, after reading, take random MCQs, try to solve them as best as possible, and do not think about the fact that, no, I have not gone through this topic, I have not read.
Because by solving MCQs, we can read retrogradely.
By solving MCQs, you can read retrogradely.
The topics we had made wrong, it will be forgotten at the time of examination.
Yes.
Definitely, it's a true.
The MCQ that you solve, let us say tonight you start solving 50 MCQs and let us say you don't get 20 out of them, 20 you get wrong. So those 20 MCQs, when you are going to revise the topics of those 20 MCQs,
definitely,
maybe 5 days or 10 days or 7 days later, you'll be able to recollect the topics
better. I made it wrong. You will definitely strike at my mind while solving those similar MCQs.
So basically, you have to analyze your errors, and your errors will always stay with you provided you work on them.
Yes,
so I think that is the take-home message. Basically, the take-home message is that divide your rest of the time into three parts: for the basics, for the clinicals, and for the other subjects like PSM. Focus mainly on the revision part. Try to align the thoughts at one place. Try to have a single source. And most importantly, do not fall in the trap of monotony. Try to read the topics, try to solve random MCQs, commit errors, no issues, but work on those errors so that you don't commit them again. That is basically the crux for it.
Basically, my concept is learning through mistakes.
Learning through mistakes. Exactly. Learning through mistakes. So hopefully, we will be having a very fantastic rank from you in PGI also. We are expecting the result also. Fingers are crossed. And very soon we will be having a very fantastic, glorious pediatrician or a intensivist with us. And of course, the country needs that. And I wish you all the best, all of the luck for your future also, for your future exams also, and interviews also. So here is we signing off from DAMS, and we'll be bringing some more interviews to you in some point of time with other toppers. So till then, best of luck. Keep studying. Bye-bye.
Thank you.